0330, July 7, 1947, Muhai's spacecraft above the Brazel crash site. Shocked by the voice, Rudy did as he was told and found himself staring at an 8mm pistol held by what looked like a mock U.S. commando. Except the beret was cocked a little funny and his sleeves were rolled up in the style of a popular toy soldier figure. He couldn't help it. The man was such a cliché that he snickered a little at the sight of him. "Hey, I know you. You're an MP from Overt Operations," Rudy belted out. He couldn't quite take this seriously. It suddenly struck him as really funny. "Who do you think you are, Commando Joe?" Laughing at his own joke, he dropped his hands. "I don't know how you got here, but since you're here, come on over. Keep your hands up, Corporal. I'll give the directions. Now step away from the control panel." Rudy started to obey, but something snapped inside him. He was not a soldier on base here. This was neutral ground, and the MP was not his commanding officer. Suddenly, he didn't care if he had to peel potatoes till doomsday. Muhai's voice broke out on the speaker, and the commando's eyes went to the screen. That was all Rudy needed. He said, "Sorry, Joe," reached out and pushed a knob. A high squeal issued from the craft. No anti-gravity this time. It lurched crazily, sending them both to the deck, but Rudy had the upper hand. He threw himself into the control chair while the commando was projected backwards. Rudy heard a thump behind him, and the 8mm came careening toward him on the floor. Then the G's closed in on Rudy, and there was silence. Rudy awoke, still seated in the control chair. He looked and saw the MP was still out cold. Two button pushes and Joe's relaxed body was floating, held by the beam. "All right, I'm getting the hang of this." The pistol was still at his feet, and he studied it. Muhai's voice came blaring into the room with exasperation. "Greeley, are you there? What happened to my ship?" Rudy spoke up. "Muhai, is that you? What do I do now?" "I think you have a stowaway." "Yes, I do." He stepped up to the floating soldier, read the name over the MP's pocket. "It's a Sergeant Tavish, an MP from the base. Thinks he's a commando. He's floating in the holding beam. Out cold. Hit the bulkhead when I started up the ship." "Congratulations, you did well, Rudy. I don't know how you did it, but thank you. We can take the soldier back as soon as I get on board. Now listen to my directions." In minutes, Muhai and the two Sartarians were on board, and they were contemplating their next move. Now Rudy was not so sure he had acted wisely. "Say, you don't have me under some kind of mind control or anything. See, I could get court-martialed for disobeying an MP, even this goofus Tavish, but I did it so easy, you must have helped me. I know you're reading my mind, so why am I even talking?" He was a little ruffled. Muhai was interested. "Please be happy. I didn't help you that much. Now, why did you say it was easy?" "I didn't have to think about disarming this guy. It just felt right. Everybody pushes me around, and I guess I'm just tired of it. The guy's way stupider than me. I mean, but I'm in the army. Now I've disobeyed an MP, even if he was kind of out of his territory. I don't know, I just did it, and now I can be in deep trouble." "Don't worry, Rudy. We will see to it that you're released from these things. No one at the base will ever know. I have to tell you, I'm not manipulating your actions. Those are your choices, always. That is beyond my capacity to operate that way." Muhai was struggling with concepts. He tried again. "Why did you decide to help us?" "Because what you guys are doing seems more important, almost like the army is just playing games and they don't even know how to use their toys to make things better." Muhai considered this, then ventured, "You are different from most of your fellow men. You seek out a different hero than they. We chose you to help us because of your independence, your empathy, and your capacity for understanding new thought. Your story characters, science fiction you call it. Those heroes go by their gut feelings, you would say. And so do you. A strong soul must follow his own belief." Rudy was satisfied with this. He rarely got compliments from his Earth brothers. He was gaining confidence now. As soon as we drop off our commando, we will go rendezvous with the home ship. Contact scheduled for 30 minutes. He tapped on a keyboard, watched for verification on a screen, looked at Rudy, back to the screen, then turned back to talk to him. Our sources tell us that Sergeant Tavish was assigned to follow you. He discovered the ship and stowed away. He did well following you, but he made a tactical error in coming alone. My ship video monitors verify this. We will have to deprogram him, fly back over to Carswell, and drop him off. Deprogram? What's that? Rudy asked. Well, that is our masking procedure that allows us to carry out a mission and erase the memories we don't want anyone to remember. Why don't you want people to remember? Greeley was still smarting from his directive to remain secret. It is mostly for your own protection. Rudy looked puzzled. How does it work? The memories are literally covered over by a stronger programming. Not even hypnotism can make the true memories emerge, for the masking works on the subconscious. You can't remember what your brain doesn't know. He continued, also, for the people of Earth, power could fall into the wrong hands. We need it for our protection, and humans need it too. You, like all creatures, want autonomy in your decisions. Free will, I believe, is your phrase. Rudy considered this and nodded. So, what are you doing with me? If you're gonna erase my memories, can I ask some questions? Muhai sighed. What do you want to know? First off, what are you doing here? On Earth, I mean. We are here as benevolent protectors. We have been here for ages. As soon as we discovered that a sentient race had developed quite alone and untouched, it is an unusual and celebrated event in the course of our duties. Alone and untouched? Untouched by who? So, what is your mission? Muhai was finding Rudy to be disarming. He deserved thoughtful answers. Untouched by outside forces with selfish agendas. Our mission is to give aid and encouragement to worlds in their quest to rise above the ancient evil that permeates the cosmos. But we do it subtly. It is our mandate to stay undetected, if at all possible, or at least to make as little impact as necessary in the natural development of things. I know all about that ancient evil stuff. Why, is Earth in danger right now? From what? Right now, from itself. It's the atom splitting that has us nervous. These craft that have succumbed to your powerful Terran storms. Your vision, you remember. We're patrolling the ozone layer of your planet for this reason. That layer suffered a rift in your early experimental explosions when the first bombs were detonated above ground and caused chain reactions that severed the protective layer clear to the mesosphere. Fortunately, we were able to subtly suggest information through other agents in key positions so that the subsequent bombs would be modified and would not further damage the ozone layer. Of course, now the problem is that the nuclear secret is out, and many of your countries, most of whom are not trustworthy, may possess nuclear bomb capabilities. We have much work in diplomacy ahead of us. So it's not danger from outer space people, but we ourselves who are causing the problems? As usual in the development of sentient races, their technical innovations often precede their emotional and spiritual development. They may have dangerous, even plant-threatening weapons before they have the wisdom to use them, even if it is claimed that they are only for deterrence. Corporal Rudy Greeley, U.S. Army Air Force, recent graduate of Arlington High, class of 43, was having trouble taking in the scope of this information, even if it was in the language of many of the authors he read. I think I understand what you're saying. I've read a lot of good stories about these things. And these aliens, I mean extraterrestrials, no harm meant. You and your brothers here. He looked at the two fantastic-looking creatures on the other side of the ship and was surprised that he was warming up to them. Are welcome here, as far as I'm concerned, 'cause